Hi everyone, it's Ken LaRue from the Shotgun Team, and here's your tip for today in the 30 Tips in 30 Days. In this tip, we're going to look at how you can create custom tabs to view different layouts of the common pages that you view inside a Shotgun. Now on a page such as your asset page, your shot page, your task page, etc., the typical workflow on any of these pages is you're going to use different grouping options, display different columns, take advantage of filtering options to view exactly the data and information that you need while viewing that page. Now in another tip, we discussed permissions and who can alter and save a default page, such as the shot page, the task page, etc. But in this tip, it doesn't matter what your role is because we're going to be creating a custom page and saving that custom page. But then we're also going to add tabs to that custom page to view different information very quickly. So here I'm looking at my shots page for this project. And the first thing I want to do is create a custom version of this page so I can start to alter and save it. So I'll go over to the page icon, I click on it, I choose Save Page As. It's going to ask me, what do you want to name this? I'm going to name this Ken's Shots. Then I'll click the Create Page button. And now we see along the top, the name is Ken's Shots, and it says private because this is my custom page. And of course, we can navigate to this page anytime we want by going to all pages, and you'll see Ken's shots are listed in here. Okay, great. Now we're still looking at the default layout of the shots page that was created by my admin. So I want to change this. That's the whole point of creating a custom page. I want to hide some columns that I don't really need for the information that I want to get. So I'll go to my project column and right click and choose hide. That's gone. I don't need the cut in column, so I'll choose hide for that also. Then I'm going to take the cut order. I'm going to drag it all the way over here. I want it to be the first column right after sequences. So now I want to save this page, this layout. So I come over to my page flyout once again, and I choose Save Page. It is now saved as the default layout for Ken's Shots. Okay, this is great, but very often I want to view a different configuration of the shot page to get different information that I need. Now, of course, I could make some changes and then choose Save As and continue to build multiple custom pages that I can then access from my All Pages flyout. But instead of doing that, that's where the tabs come in. We can create multiple layouts to show different data and different information and access them by using the tabs on one page. So to do this, I'm going to go back to my page flyout and I'll choose Design Page. Now we're in the design mode. And we can see this tab's name is default, and that's fine. I want to have this, but I want to duplicate this, alter it, and then rename the other tab. I could choose New View and create a new page, or I can just click on the name default, and from the flyout, I'll choose Duplicate View. Now you'll see this tab is named Default Copy. Let's change the grouping of this. So I don't want this set to be grouped by sequence. I want it set by the asset. Then I want to change a filter option. So I go over to my filters, I'll come down, I'll enable in progress as a filter, and I'm going to come over to my default copy, click on that, and let's rename this. Now I'll rename this tab or this view to asset progress. Let's create another tab. Once again, I'll come up to the tab, I'll click on it, I'll choose duplicate view. So now I've got a copy of the asset progress one. Now I want to alter this view, so I'm going to hide some of the columns. This time, assets. I'm going to hide assets on this one. I don't want to see the assets. Open notes, hide that one also. I don't need that. I'll move the status column right next to sequence, so that's now the first column after sequence. And I'm going to go to my grouping, and I'm going to choose cut in as the grouping order. Lastly, I'll go to my filtering, and I'm going to disable the in progress. I want all of the shots, whether they're waiting to start, final, in progress, or ready to start, to be displayed. So now I've altered and changed the layout to a new configuration, and I want to rename this one. So again, I'll click the little triangle, I'll choose rename, and I'll rename this view to cut order all. Then click rename view. So now we have three different tabs, or views if you will, for the same page. When I choose save in the upper right corner, we exit out of the design mode and we go back to the Ken's shot page. Now look over here along the right hand side. We now have access to those tabs or views that we just created. We're looking at the default because that's the last one we were looking at inside the design mode. But if I want to look at the tab, the view of asset progress, I click on it. You'll notice that my whole page changes and it's giving me different information, different data. I click on the cut order all, I now look at that layout. So this is a great way of being able to get the information you need very quickly instead of going into your grouping and switching the grouping, changing the filtering and so on, or even the layout. You can create these custom tabs on any page. Also, it's a lot easier than going and creating all these new custom pages and then accessing them all from the all pages. Keep in mind, this whole workflow of the tabs and the design page works on all your pages that have the columns and the different information you want. So if I go to my all page flyout, I can go to my asset page, and here I can go again to the page icon, choose save page as, and then I can go into the design mode. If I go to the task page, again, all the same options are available to you to create the custom tabs. So that's our tip for today, 30 tips in 30 days.